isolated and alone, an island unlike no other. A land of stunning coastlines, ancient forests and rugged mountains. An island where over 40% of the land has been unexplored, untouched and unrecorded in modern history. Parts so remote, so rugged, only the brave dared adventure. 103 riders from all over the world will descend upon Tasmania for the adventure of a lifetime. This will be no easy Sunday ride. Riders and machines will be tested and pushed in every way. Tasmania is begging for adventure and the riders have heard its call. Welcome to the 2023 Husky Trek. Our adventure starts in the sleepy town of Smithton. Riders from Spain, Argentina, Austria and all over Australia have converged here for the starting point of the trek.
Hi everyone, here we are in the southern island of Australia. We're in Tasmania for the 2023 Husky Trek. It's going to be the biggest Husky Trek yet, and I can't wait to get out and see what's in store for us on this super little island.
That's what the goal is.
How you doing, Rosie?
001.
Yeah, I know. How good's that, eh? If only my talent was equal to the number.
Another Husky Trek. Are you excited?
Yeah, number 3 for me.
And in Tasmania.
Yeah, beautiful. How beautiful is this place?
James, back for another Husky Trek.
Here we are, 2023 in Tasmania.
So you said your bike has a few more kilometres on it now.
It is more than 2 days old this year, yes.
But are you excited for another Husky Trek?
Can't wait. Can't wait.
Greg?
Yes?
You're back for another Husky Trek?
Yes, I am. I am in Tassie, which is brilliant. It's a bit cold, but that's all right. That's all right. It's pretty good. It was a good ride up from Launceston through all the stuff that you showed us to come and see. It was brilliant. Very nice.
And this year?
I've got a friend.
Thanks, mate.
Peter's decided to come.
Can't wait. Awesome.
Your first Husky Trek, are you excited?
Absolutely, super excited.
So this one talked you into it?
Didn't take much convincing.
Awesome. I mean, 5 days on a Husky in Tasmania. Yeah. Look, the sun's out. Can it get any better?
Absolutely not.
Yeah.
Awesome week.
With bike checks complete, GPS loaded and the rider numbers allocated, beers are poured and the rider briefing begins.
Welcome! Welcome to the 2023 Husqvarna Motorcycles Husky Trek Tasmania! Are you guys as excited as I am to be here? This little event started way back in 2019 and we had just under 40 riders. And today it has grown to we have 103 Husky Trek riders here. So thank you all for supporting this event. We are very honored to have special guests all the way from Austria. They are from head office and they are here to see how things are done at the Husky Trek Australia, which I think is pretty amazing. We also have some special groups with us. Where is he? There he is. Another round of applause for Lyndon. Thank you very much for being here. Stop and give a big round of applause for Team Argentina!
Euro champion, she's an Aussie champion, and she is an amazing lady. Gemma Wilson at the back there.
Gemma, very excited to spend the next 5 days with you guys on Husky Trek 2023. Have a good night, and we'll see you all for day one tomorrow.
With excitement and eagerness upon the riders, an early night was to be had as the first day would see the riders complete 273 kilometres travelling down the Western Explorer and through the rugged wilderness area known as the Tarkine.
Alright team, so we are about 30 minutes away from the riders departing on day one of the 2023 Husky Trek down here in Tasmania. We're in Smithton right now, and then everyone's gonna get on the road, get on the dirt and the Western Explorer and work their way down to Strawn for tonight's dinner and home base. It's gonna be an epic ride, barge crossing involved, a couple of hard routes in there. That final one right at the end is a four chili, so that's gonna be pretty spicy out on the sand. It's gonna be another epic start to another epic Husky Trek here in Tasmania.
Day one of the Husky Trek, sun's shining. We're about to head off down the west coast, a part of Tasmania that I have never seen before. And I'm just so excited to get out on my Norden with some epic suspension and ride with some cool people.
Day one in tall timbers. About to head over to Strawn, over the hill. Hopefully do some beach riding, should be good.
What can you expect from today?
Mate, I'm just gonna take it easy, enjoy the scenery, and first time over in Tassie actually, so yeah, just here to enjoy the scenery really.
Is this a bit of a bucket list sort of ride for you?
Oh, definitely mate. After seeing the last Husky Trek, I was like, oh, I have to be part of one of these.
Are you ready for Husky Trek Part 2?
I am ready.
Yes.
I believe so.
And the weather, look at it. No, there's some clouds over there, but not a cloud up here.
Yeah. But I am packing for
cold, wind, rain, snow, sun. Yeah. It's Tassie. If you don't like the weather, wait 5 minutes.
All right. I better go. Curve is waiting.
Have fun. Go get some bangers.
Woo! Yeah.
Guess who forgot to fill up with fuel this morning? But look at this. Chase crew are here already. Let's see their reaction to getting some fuel. Put a smile on his face already. You got some fuel, please?
What? Fuel? Are you for real? You know there's a servo when we took off this morning.
There was, you're right. Guess who didn't fill up?
Guess who lost his wallet?
We'll be right back.
easy morning for the first day. I think a lot of people might get lulled into a false sense of easiness.
Yeah.
And it's not going to be like that. So it's good for a warm up. Looking forward to this afternoon when we get into some hotter stuff.
While a sense of easiness may have been installed upon the riders, a quick stop for lunch at the historic town of Corinna and a ferry across the famous Pyman River would be all that stands between them and a spicy four chili hard route at Ocean Beach.
You're going to get into the boat across the river to the other side. Let's see what's we can find on the other side.
I don't think the track goes up there.
That was the best.
You gotta have some fun, eh?
Bill, how'd you go today?
Yeah, ripper day. Ripper day. Just good to be down in Tassie.
Is this your first time adventure riding here?
Yeah, oh, first time riding in Tassie for sure.
Okay, yeah. What was the highlight? What was the highlight of the day?
The mossy sections. It was like loamy, sandy. It was beautiful. I thought it was going to be slippery. I'm used to Queensland. You see green, it's going to be slippery. This wasn't. It was just like throttle on.
Gordon, day one, Husky Trek Australia.
Yeah, quite amazing, I would say.
Was
really
it good?
Really good. It's been a lot of fun. Plenty of riders, there's so many people to talk to experience something with them. You know, we had road, we had sand, we had rocks, we had jungle, I would say, deep water, mud, everything. And yeah, a lot of stories to share then later at the table.
So we've just finished day one of the Husky Trek 2023 in Tasmania. What a day. It was 280 kilometers today, and we had a few breakouts along the way, which is, a breakout is a term for a technical section, and they range from chili one to chili five. So today we had a couple of chili threes, which was really interesting. The first one was like grass and mud, super slippery, hard packed surface. And that caught a few people out. I saw a few bikes facing the wrong way on that track. Some big bog holes to pass through, a couple of stuck bikes. Then we had some really long, fast, rocky tracks, and they're awesome. I love those. So had a lot of fun on those, undulating over the hills, lots of rocks and jumps and yumps. That was good fun. And then the last one of the day, when we came towards the finish of the day, was on the beach. And that definitely caught some people out getting onto the beach because it was super soft sand. But once we got onto the beach and it opened up, we had an amazing time. We were all playing around on the beach, doing skids and jumps and wheelies and all sorts. So all in all, a really good day with all the transfer sections in between, making what is a day at the Husky Trek. People are fantastic. Everyone's back here tonight for dinner and another fantastic meal, which is always good. And we're just wrapping up the evening with a couple of drinks early night. And we've got to do it all again tomorrow because tomorrow's a huge day at over 400 kilometers, even for the easy route, and 450 kilometers almost for the hard route. So go get a good night's sleep and get back on it tomorrow.
While laughter spilled out into the night with many sharing their stories of the day, day two awaited the riders for a 440-kilometre transit to Orford.
Day two, we're about to head off for a little bit of a road liaison section, so I'm definitely layered up, ready for that. And then really looking forward to some breakouts this afternoon. There's quite a long breakout at the end of the day, which sounds like it has a little bit of everything in. I'm excited to get in there on my Norden, and hopefully the sun stays out and we have an awesome day.
Start of day two Husky Trek.
Very important cargo today. I have to behave myself all day and be a good boy today.
And why is that?
Because I have very important cargo on the bike.
It's a BIC, not VIP.
It's a BIC. Yay, I'm super excited. Having a taxi ride with Lyndon.
He's already prepared for the cold.
Exactly, wrapped up in 10 layers. Yeah. So we will see us on the other side.
Yeah, my friends are paying for it though, that's a good thing.
Now, are you having fun?
Almost.
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 Almost. So almost. What would make this more fun?
The breakout up the road, I can't wait.
Oh, exciting. So fuel up.
Fuel up. Get to the breakout, fall off.
Perfect.
So, what do you need after riding all day with nothing in the middle of nowhere? What you need is a little coffee shop that's opened, especially because she knew we were coming through. Look at this. We are spoiled. We are spoiled at Botero Coffee Shop. Cheers to that. Let's find out how Paula's getting on. Paula, how was your first experience on an adventure ride?
It was great. I love it. I love to be here and enjoy it.
Good.
Looking forward for more.
It's been a long day.
And yes.
We also did some off-road.
Yeah. That was amazing. I loved it. That was the best part of all. It was my favorite.
I was sweating the whole way through it. But you were fine on the back.
I'm fine.
And I have to say, I'll get both of us in the picture. We did a little jump and Paula wanted to go back and do a bigger jump, which was good fun. So, well done. I'm glad you enjoyed it. We've still got a bit to go, so for now we can get coffee and cake. So, happy days. Look at that. That is called an adventure cake board. And they're going, that, all of it is going in our bellies.
I don't know, with sugar?
Stomachs full of cake and coffee and a visit from one of Australia's most venomous snakes, riders would check out one of Australia's first hydroelectric power stations and then get back on the road and head to tonight's home base at Orford.
I snuffed her out. Ah, yeah. Bit heavy on fuel in here. Thanks, mate.
I just seen your bike. I think, where the f*** is he?
Husqvarna's got an awesome day and an awesome event again. All due to lovely Lady Rosie.
We pay him well or he's full of s***. We're not sure. Macca? Bit of motorcycle maintenance?
Yes. I think I might have posted it.
Too much fuel, no tyre, and zero talent. It makes it very difficult to perform.
That's a man.
That's a wrap.
Hey,
up, who did that Swanson track today? You definitely know what a four chili is after doing that track today. So that was impressive. Well done to everybody. What a great day too for the Fair Dinkum Award, because somebody had their 40th wedding anniversary yesterday. Yeah, and he's on this ride, and guess what? He bought his wife for his 40th wedding anniversary. A Husky Expedition. Happy anniversary! It's a beautiful bike. Your wife is gonna love it.
It's a pretty big day tomorrow. If you're gonna tackle all the hard routes, it's probably bigger than today. In fact, it is bigger than today. So if you're gonna get stuck into them, make sure that you leave as early as you can, so be all geared up, ready to go at 8.
Everybody have a great night, and we'll see you tomorrow for day 3!
With day 3 upon us, many riders were beginning to understand what the trek was all about. While friendships were being forged and cold beers were drunk, day 3 awaited our riders of 369 kilometres with the option of 6 hard routes for day 3 to St Helens.
Resort in the little town of Orford. We're just about to kick off day 3 of the Husky Trek. We have had 2 great days so far. Day 1 eased the riders into it with some epic scenery, some amazing tracks, and a little bit of spice in those hard routes. And then yesterday we definitely showed them what Tasmania has to offer. There was some amazing tar seal. We went through some great little towns, and then there was definitely a hard route at the end of the day that made the riders work for it. But everyone came into town with a great smile on their face. Amazing dinner last night. Can't wait to kick off today. We're going to explore the amazing Ben Lomond and Jacob's Ladder and in St. Helens tonight.
I'm gonna erase you for taking what's mine. Brother, you best move if you're gonna hide. Oh, maybe you don't know when, but you know the reason why. Save your breath, cause you know one time you dug a hole, but never learn how to climb. Oh, you made the bed you made, and I'm here to say goodnight.
Yes!
Well done! Oh, pick it up! Pick it up! Pick it up!
That's not going anywhere.
What's going on here, lads? Oh! Hello! What's happened here?
On-road maintenance.
Yeah. Is it got a misfire in it?
Misfire?
There's no water on the speedway tracks, is there?
It's a trouble. It's only running on one cylinder.
Oh, yeah. Jesus.
like a pond. Fish pond.
Oh, wow.
Wobble it. Yeah.
She's drowned. 20 minutes, be back on the trail again.
What a place to ride a motorcycle. We're just heading up to Ben Lomond. So this is the famous Jacob's Ladder. Probably seen it 1,000 times in probably every magazine, every motorcycle magazine for sure. So yeah, first time here, super stoked to be here. Pretty excited.
This track this morning has been the best ride we've had all week. Yeah, it's pretty cool. Yeah.
Is this sort of like one of those bucket list rides for you guys? Something that you read about, you see about?
We saw it on the YouTube last year, the Queensland one. And as soon as I saw it, I said, oh, we've got to get some. So we bought bikes just to do this one event we have. And I've got two other boys, so we'll go back to Port. They'll get bikes for next year and we'll be four of us on that trail. It's pretty cool. Yeah.
That's pretty so cool. Epic.
What's going on, mate?
Well, we're sort of helping mate out. Ooh, someone ran out of fuel. I'm not sure who it was. Do you know, Geordie?
Little bike?
It's a little bike, yes.
May have been on a loud fist, maybe. Oh, too much.
Yeah, I reckon someone was on the pipe. Ran out of juice. But, lucky I've got a spare 20 litres.
It's a a bit of a common thing, you helping me out.
It is a bit Geordie.
Beer tonight, oh yeah.
Oh yeah. Well, there was four stubbies here, so four stubbies, that's fair enough, wasn't it?
Mister, can you stop for me? I ain't got much besides this guitar. Back a ways you'd find what else I own. The trunk of that damn old car. Don't know what blew, but it's smoking like hell. And man, it sure don't sound good.
That was the day, Rob. I think the day was New Zealand level riding. It was outstanding. Amazing tracks, slippery, bog holes, good climbs, rocky stuff, pretty much everything in one day.
Okay, so how was your day?
It was one of the best days riding ever, according to Mark. Yeah, easily was.
And according to Michael?
It was too. Very good. Very good.
Just not your bog hole.
Just not my bog hole. Where I got bog I don't like, prior to that great, bog hole no good.
Mr. Poskett.
Hey.
Good day?
Yeah, very good day. Long day, but good day. Very good. Lots of interesting tracks, technical, fast and open, beautiful scenery. Really, really awesome day.
Find the same fortune on this here California coast. To tell the truth, long shots of
our whiskey. I'm a little bit tired after a big day, but who had fun today? I heard the words best day ever, except for the schoolhouse. Changing over 50 tires for you guys. So let's raise the roof and they might hear us. Scott's Motorcycles outside, well done!
The mic route, 220 kilometers. There's a bit to see, but it's pretty cruisy. It's not too techy. So pretty cruisy. The hard route, not as cruisy. There's a few logs on it, there's rocks, workouts, and then you'll pop back out on the road. So, awesome on the dirt bikes. It's a proper mission getting up there on the adventure bikes, but for those who want to have a crack, it's really cool. It's a really cool thing. So.
You had a sensational day three, and we will see you tomorrow for day four of the Husky Trek. Thank you all!
Day 4 holds a little bit of magic as the riders transit through dirty. Some of the best trails and hard routes await the riders. 274 kilometres through to Derby and 5 hard route options, the best day ever could happen yet again.
So here we are at day 4 of the Husky Trek in Tasmania, and we've got what seems like a relatively short day today because it's the shortest yet at 270 kilometres, but I think that's a bit deceiving because there's a lot of breakouts, breakouts with technical riding. I think there's going to be some log hopping, there's going to be some rocky trails, tight twisty single tracks through forests. We're riding through some like rainforest with ferns and everything. I think it's gonna be a long day. So I'm looking forward to getting out there. There's a lot of riders looking a bit apprehensive today after 3 days of intense riding already. But we're on day 4, one more day tomorrow. So we're over the halfway, over the hill as they say, and ready to go out and have a great day.
Start of day 4. How is the Northern Expedition going?
Very well, exceptionally well. It's got a problem though. It doesn't like its rear tire. It keeps eating it.
That has nothing to do with the rider at all.
No.
Day 4. Here we go. 5 breakouts.
Can't wait.
Good looking day.
Gear, let the clutch out, sit down, let the clutch out and push with your feet and just keep pushing. Don't be tempted to stop, just keep going, like really aggressive, and as soon as it goes over there, pull the clutch, okay? And just bah, and go, and don't shut off. Go! See, hesitated, don't pull the clutch.
Yeah, we're gonna struggle getting the arse out, eh?
Pick it up over there.
Hey?
Yeah.
Oh shit. Oh, quick.
Bit more.
Venture's a strategy and we're playing it. Three, two, one. Oh, wait, wait, I'll get the wheel in.
Ready?
Thanks, Greg. No way I was getting out of that.
Oh, wow.
My mate, Greg McFarlane, always there to pick up the pieces. Aren't you, mate?
Don't worry about that. You're a good bloke. Too easy.
Out the window, we can wake up anywhere tomorrow. It don't matter where we go, we're going somewhere. Turn it all around, hang it upside down. We can get a little lost and found. It don't matter where we are, but no, we're getting there. Touching down in the middle of your hometown. Every mile we're getting there. You and I got a room on top of the world. Taking off.
endless bog holes, technical single trail, and summiting Siamese Ridge, riders were treated to a cold drink and hot meal at the World Republic. A few laughs and stories told about their morning, and riders set off for the famous Ringarooma River track.
Never used to like sand, but I love it after that H4. That was absolutely mint. That was so good.
As good as it gets, eh?
It was as good as it gets, really was. Leroy came out there and he goes, yo, with all the ride I've done over the years, that's by far top 10 trail ever. A couple of boys looped back for second laps at it, so they liked it that much.
Awesome riding. Best day ever. Let's hope tomorrow it keeps going, gets better.
How'd the big girl go through the bush?
She went all right, mate. I didn't, she did.
Smile of the day is dirty air filler. No, what an epic day. Day 4, Tasmania. Proper adventure riding. Saw it all today. Had a really, really, really fun day. Just lovely flowy, everything from single track to wide open fast track, fast flowing technical tracks, tracks through, it was like riding in the rainforest, like canopies of trees at some point. Just everything you could think of was really good, and just seeing the smiles on everyone's faces. Every time I saw another rider, big smiles, everyone happy, everyone doing what they love in a fantastic place. Great organization, great event. Leftovers on the counter. Kids with the television. And the sink is full of flowers. Bathtub soaking the dishes. Got a couch in the
Samaritans, people
have stopped riders on the street to say what an amazing sight and what amazing people the Husky Riders are.
With a full stomach and smiles all around, day four comes to an end. Tomorrow would bring the end to a 1700 kilometre adventure, but the best was yet to come with one more epic adventure filled day.
It is kind of chilly, but it's last day, so everyone is looking forward to it. Coffee is good and food is good, so it's a good start to the day.
All ready to roll, last day. Pretty excited. Yeah, little donkey has got me through. God, look at that thing.
Oh my God.
It's a bit dirty.
It is a bit dirty, but it's been fun. I think there's a lot of smiles yesterday. I don't think there was a sad place or a sad person in the place. It was cool. One of Tasmania's best-kept secrets, Bridport Beach, offered riders the unique experience of surfing sand dunes like they were at the Dakar Rally. And with the sun shining and perfect blue skies, you couldn't have asked for a better day to play at the beach.
So I was having lots of fun in the sand dunes, and my clutch got a little bit hot on the Norden, and so I just rang Louis, our mechanic, en route, and yeah, he just explained to me that I was going the wrong way with the free play. It's away from me equals more free play, not me equals more. So I'm all sorted and I have some free play and I'll just get myself off the beach now and stop being an idiot in the sand.
We're not going to send it up the hill one more time?
Not one more time, no.
From one extreme to the other, straight from the sea and back to the mountains, riders explored the narrow switchbacks of Mount Barrow, the smaller version of Ben Lomond, and with just a stunning view.
Approximately. Just about every single terrain you can imagine. Amazing people, amazing organisation. It's been epic, really. It's been really good. Full tour of the island, north, south, east and west, high mountain points, the highest points of the island, right down to the lowest points, in the sea even for some of us. Yeah, you can't ask for much more, really. Really, really enjoyable 5 days. Bike did great. I rode the Norton 901 and just enjoyed every minute of it. Really, really good time.
Husky Trek Australia, you've done it.
Yes, I got my finisher sticker. So officially finished and I'm done. I'm cooked. The beach gave me the rest. Was really cool. Was the best of the whole event, but also the hardest. So the worst in my eyes. It killed me off, but real fun.
So what do you think of Husky Trek Australia?
It's a nice event. I mean, talk to the guys here. They will give all the same answer. Amazing, crazy organization, so much riding, different terrain, variety, good food, and I think a lot new of contacts, of friends in the end. Yeah? Husky Trek makes a family. That's it.
First Husky Trek, how was it?
Absolutely amazing. We'll be back for more.
I do it's fine.
Don't worry, it's a good job. Trees and leaves rolling during the dinosaur. I've driven by for
ages. Street lights shine. This life I've built. This old town never changes. I take my heels into this dirt.
Oh, the trek was unreal. Amazing trails, just an awesome bunch of people. Actually, the weather turned it on. It was perfect every single day. Cameraman, he was amazing. Did a great job.
Four-wheel drive support out the sand dunes. He went all right.
That was a good couple of days. Good. Amazing. Yeah. Yeah. Recommended to anyone. Anyone who's thinking about it, jump on board. Get over to Husky Trek.
I dig my heels into this dirt I love. I know that all I have is more than enough.
What an amazing 5 days, and to top it off with the best weather that we had all week. Did you guys have fun today for day 5 of the Husky Trek?
Like-minded people riding adventure bikes, doing what they love. And I think that's all I can say. Thank you, everyone. Cheers.
Man, what a place to ride a motorcycle.
Husqvarna Motorcycles.